Welcome to our case study of the One Meridian Plaza fire. Our group members are Renier Duran, Rachel Gularte, Tricia Montoya, Andres Hernandez, and Nicholas Caldaras. Tricia will be introducing our case study. Next, Andres will be presenting the incident timeline. Rachel will be presenting our plot plan discussion. Renier will discuss the immediate results of the incident, and Nicholas will discuss the lessons learned after the fire. This is the One Meridian Plaza fire.
On February 23, 1991, the Philadelphia Fire Department received a call that would change this nation forever. At approximately 2023, firefighters responded to a call at the One Meridian Plaza. The fire was reported to be on the 22nd floor of the 38-floor high-rise tower. The fire started in a vacant 22nd floor office in a pile of linseed oil-soaked rags left by a contractor. The activation of a smoke detector on the 22nd floor was the first notice of a possible fire. The signal was sent to the Central Station Fire Alarm Company. Instead of notifying the fire department, they called building personnel to investigate. After nearly 20 minutes of burning, the fire department was notified by a bystander instead of the building company. The fire was already well advanced before the fire department was notified. The fire brought 51 engine companies, over 300 firefighters, 11 specialized units, and 15 ladder companies to the scene to battle the blaze. Three firefighters from engine company 11 died on the 28th floor when they became disoriented and ran out of air in their SCBAs. After the loss of three personnel, hours of unsuccessful attack on the fire with several floors simultaneously involved in the fire, and a risk of structural collapse, the incident commander withdrew all personnel from the building due to the uncontrollable risk factors. The fire ultimately spread up to the 30th floor and was stopped by 10 automatic sprinklers. One Meridian was one of the largest high-rise fires recorded in U.S. history. It was controlled by the use of 10 sprinkler heads activated at different points in the fire. The fire spread nearly 8 floors until it finally reached the 30th floor, which was the only floor that had automatic sprinkler systems installed. This led to the huge realization that fire sprinkler systems was a necessity and could drastically control fires and reduce the amount of damage. The fire proved that sprinkler systems needed to be required installation in all high-rise buildings and could have a huge addition to fire protection. By the time the 12th alarm was declared under control 19 hours later, three firefighters were dead, 12 others were injured, and city center high-rise was lost. The blaze over 20 years ago changed the city skyline and the way the nation fights high-rise fires. Following the fire at One Meridian Plaza, it became mandatory that all high-rise buildings be retrofitted with sprinkler systems in order to avoid incidents like this one.
Today, I'm going to share with you 8 key events that happened during the fire. Initial response. The first alarm assigned 4 engine companies, 2 ladder companies, and 2 battalion chiefs. The first unit on the scene was Engine 43. Battalion Chief George Yeager called for a second alarm. He set a command post and a lobby in a safety zone. He ordered Chief Mike Kowalski to initiate the attack. Chief Kowalski took the elevator to the 11th floor and walked to the 22nd floor. Loss of electrical power. Shortly after the chief reached the 11th floor, total electrical power was lost. He left the building without electrical power for the rest of the incident. Personnel had to use the stairs to get to the 20th floor. Initial attack. On the way to the 22nd floor, they began encountering smoke in the stairways. They quickly learned that the stairs tower door was locked. A ladder company was assigned to open. Once open, the crew realized they could not work on the 22nd floor. Chief Kalmeski ordered firefighters to set a staging area on the 20th floor and tactical command post on the 21st floor. Water problem. On the 22nd floor, water pressure was a problem. The 1 3/4 inch water hose require 100 psi, but the standpipe outlets only produce 60 psi. Missing firefighters. Smoke was building up in the stairways. Engine 11 was assigned to ventilate the stairways. At 10:20 p.m., a message was received reporting that they were disoriented on the 30th floor. Moments later, another message was received reporting that captain was down. A search team was sent to find him. They were unable to find them due to heavy smoke and running out of air. A second search team was sent, and at this time they found them on the 28th floor. All 3 members lost their lives.
Fire operation suspended. For the safety of the firefighters, the operation was suspended. A 2-inch crack on the concrete wall had grown into fist-sized opening and a possible pancake collapse. The automatic sprinklers helped the fire stop at the 30th floor. At 3 p.m. February 24th, the fire was declared under control.
Here's a breakdown on how many units were in the incident. It was managed by 11 battalion chiefs. Here are the details of the 12 alarms that were sounded.
The
The One Meridian Plaza only had one side of the building not facing a street. All department apparatuses not engaged in water supply were staged outside the safety zone, which was 1.5 height of the building. The initiating fire attack, firefighters took elevators to the 11th floor and walked to the 22nd in the West Stair Tower. Second alarm units were on standby in the lobby while the building engineer attempted to make other elevators operational. It was at this time that the primary and emergency power failed. Second alarm units were sent up the center stair tower to the 20th floor, where personnel, equipment and staging area, and logistics and tactical command were established. One of the new arriving units was ordered to check all standpipe outlets on the way up the stairs. Medic units were set up in the lobby. Submersible pumps were placed in the basement to protect the transformer supplying the neighboring building, the Mellon building. The transformer ended up failing and they lost power. Three members of Engine 11 were ordered to the roof via the center stairways to open the bulkhead doors to help vent the stairwell. Rescue teams searched floors 30, 31, 32, and 33 for the missing firefighters. After a helicopter noted a broken window on the 28th floor, it dropped off a unit to vent the stair towers, assist in rescue, and assist any injured firefighters. Evacuation was then ordered and all personnel were ordered to leave the building.
The Meridian Fire and its effects have endured the 27 years since it occurred. The way high-rise fires are fought changed that fateful night. However, we cannot forget the immediate tolls the fire had, to include line-of-duty deaths of Philadelphia Fire Captain David P. Holcomb, age 52, firefighter Phyllis McAllister, age 43, and firefighter James Chapel, age 29, all career firefighters with the Philadelphia Fire Department. Additionally, 12 firefighters were also treated for injuries to include minor burns and extreme fatigue. In total, 8 floors were destroyed, destroying nearly 140,000 of office floor space inside the heart of Philadelphia. The fire total cost was approximately $100 million in direct property loss. However, the fire did not cause collapse. It did cause significant enough damage to the building that it was declared a total loss and was demolished in 1999, 8 years after the fire.
Here are some of the lessons learned following the One Meridian Plaza fire. The impact of this catastrophe could have been lessened if the fire alarm systems had been working properly and the private service monitoring the fire had alerted the fire department when the first alarm was activated. The fire code was significantly improved to avoid these issues from reoccurring in the future. The code now requires buildings to maintain alarm systems and fire suppression systems operating at all times, to notify the fire department immediately of the activation of any fire alarm signal, and to retransmit alarm signals to the fire department. In addition, section 53400 of the code creates changes specifically for high-rise buildings. This section of the code requires the installation of smoke detectors in each dwelling unit, self-closing doors that lead to common corridors, the installation of water supplies and fire suppression systems on all floors of the building, a written detailed description of methods and schedules to come into compliance with these requirements. Lastly, section 3105 of the code requires wet standpipe systems to be installed in high-rise buildings where standpipes are more than 275 feet away from the fire department connection to the roof or highest area, and annual testing of standby emergency electrical systems. Thank you for watching.